Hey, I'm Thomas Zurbuchen, also known as Dr. Z.
And I'm Ellen Stofan, also known as Dr. E. And welcome to another episode of Easy Science.
And I'm so glad to be here with you, right next to the headquarters building at NASA, which, just in time for Women's History Month, has a new name, the Mary Jackson Headquarters. And I'm just so excited to have that name on it. What do you know about Mary Jackson?
Well, I learned about Mary Jackson from reading the book Hidden Figures and then, of course, seeing the movie. And, you know, she's just this amazing woman who wanted to become an engineer at NASA. She wanted to take the classes. They wouldn't let her in the school. It was for whites only. She fought to get a place in the class, got her certification, and became the first black woman engineer at NASA. And just the perseverance she had to show, she knew she belonged. She knew that they needed her help to help get the first humans into space, and she persevered. Amazing.
Today we want to talk about women in astronomy, and who are the names that come to mind when you think about women in astronomy, kind of in the context of Women's History Month?
You know, what I love is that the history of women in astronomy goes back very, very far. Women have always been there. They've always been making contributions. Many people have heard of the famous astronomer William Herschel, but his sister Caroline actually used his telescopes and discovered a number of comets. There's a woman I particularly admire named Phoebe Waterman Haas. She was one of the first women to operate the Lick telescope. Women like Henrietta Leavitt, who worked up at the Harvard Observatory and invented the way that we actually learned how to measure the distance to other galaxies. So women were there making fundamental discoveries, helping the science move along, but we don't know their stories as well as we should.
One of my favorite women who have really made history in astronomy is Dr. Nancy Grace Roman.
What amazed me about her is she had this opportunity to create an entire NASA science program, saying if you were going to lay out this astrophysics program, it's got to have a strong research component, people doing the basic understanding of how do stars form, how do galaxies evolve. How do we develop instrumentation and keep making better and better instruments to measure stars and galaxies? And then she also, of course, that critical piece for NASA, helped to really push the development of satellite after satellite after satellite.
In fact, there's a number of people who have told me that it's hard to imagine Hubble being in space if it wasn't for Nancy Grace Roman. And many people therefore refer to her as the mother of Hubble. And so I'm so excited because right after the web that we're going to launch later this year, the next big telescope has now her name on it, Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope.
So it's really going to be able to give us a comprehensive, high-resolution picture, if you will, of the universe in the infrared, really helping us understand the structure and origin of galaxies, really getting at a lot of the forces in the history of the universe as we try to understand what is the structure of the universe, what does it tell us, how can we learn the origins of the universe, how it evolves over time. What I really love is this idea that when we had the Hubble Space Telescope, which Nancy Grace Roman pioneered, it caused us to rewrite astronomy textbooks. The James Webb Space Telescope is going to take us to the next level, but then the Nancy Grace Roman Telescope will again really fundamentally change and expand our understanding of the universe.
And I know from just the last years of her life, she was excited about dark energy, which of course relates to the largest scale structure of the universe that requires the type of measurements at large field of view, 100 times that field of view of Hubble that this telescope was enabled. So we couldn't be more excited to have her name on this next generation telescope and have her legacy celebrated in the heavens with all the thousands of scientists who are waiting for those data.
Thanks to NASA for naming this building after Mary W. Jackson. And of course, thanks to all these women that we're celebrating, these scientists and engineers who helped us move the sciences forward. And thank you for joining us for another episode of Easy Science.